And welcome to another episode of Hereford FC here on Vanilla FM. And today is the 2nd of January in the game of 2024. And also, well, actually today's the 3rd of January in real life, for me anyway, in 2024. But yeah, so today we're going to take a look at transfers. There has been a request from one of you guys. So I thought I'd come around on the 20th, on the 1st of January. In fact, the 2nd of January, and do my usual transfer prep. So, just to give you a bit of context, I gave you essentially my method in the last episode of how I look for new players, and I then usually do that at the beginning of the season, so in July, and then I repeat the process in the winter transfer, even though in this league we don't really have a transfer window in the winter. It's just basically a continuous window almost until the end of the season, but I thought I'll keep that going anyway because it's a good habit to have anyway. So here we are, it's the 2nd of January. I will show you how the game is going. So if we jump into competitions, we since the last episode, we have been knocked out of the FA Trophy on the third round by Oldham Athletic, who play in the league above us. In the league, we are top of the league with 26 games, 56 points, so we have some margin for error, which is nice. Yeah, so it's going well, top of the league. We're not hemorrhaging money. We're quite healthy money-wise, which is nice, and we've got a few upgrades on the way. So if we look at the board, we actually bought the stadium, or planning to buy the stadium anyway, and we are in the progress of improving our youth facilities, and we've also improved our junior coaching as well, which is nice. In fact, let me see if there's anything else we can agree, since we have some money. So I'm just going to make some random requests for things that I think might be useful. In fact, these two might be useful for now. Let's do that. Probably should have done that in advance. But anyway, let's jump into the scouting tab. Players, plays in range. So this is where I do the scouting for what I want to do. So if we start from the first filter, so I have pre-made filters with all the key attributes for each role. So just before we finished the last episode, I went ahead and put a bid in for Tyler Dickinson, and we actually got him. So he's joined the squad, and he was meant to be replacing Russ, but actually I decided to keep Russ and keep Russ on as a mentor. He's on a zero contract anyway, so I don't have to pay him, so he's not costing the club any money, and he's staying on as basically just mentoring the other two guys. Now you can't see it on here, but I have a third goalkeeper on loan, Bradley Foster. He's the backup goalkeeper. The reason you can't see it on the scouting tab is because on here, for some reason, it doesn't show us players that we have on loan, but who are on loan from a higher league. It's because of my scouting budget, so it won't show us players from a higher league, because Bradley is actually affiliated with a different club from, which league is it? West Brom. So West Brom, yeah, Championship. So he actually won't come up in our scouting tab, which is a bit weird. It should do, but it doesn't. Anyway, so you can probably see on the left side of the screen that I've got my notes up there. And so you can see Tyler is a new player. I'm keeping Russ as a backup. And Bradley Foster is the bench goalkeeper, let's say. And they have these numbers next to their name. That is the basically the lowest key attribute that they have. So if you look at Tyler's, the lowest key attribute that it has is anticipation and positioning, and they're both rated at 10. So that is essentially the rating that I gave him overall. Now we're going to try and find another goalkeeper with 10, see if there are any others out there. And no, which means that there's no more changes that we're going to do to the goalkeepers. We're going to keep those as they are. Let's keep going down the filters and then you'll kind of get the gist of what I'm doing. So, right, inverted fullback. It says there's no one, but that can't be right. Let's take that off. Nope. What is going on here? Why is it saying... Oh, because they're both on loan. Ah, okay. Yeah, so that's that little annoying bug. So, Darren. Inverted fullback, defense. The lowest attribute he has is 9, which is still the same. In fact, I didn't look at Bradley to see if he's still the same. 10, 9. Yeah, okay. And then Nana. 9. Okay. So these guys are still the same. So let's remove Hereford and put in... See if we can find anyone better. There's this guy here, J. Rowe. But I don't think we'll be able to get him. We can't get any more loans. We could try and make an offer of 0. Yeah, that's not going to cut it. Okay, so these guys stay as well. There's no further... Actually, could I make a higher offer? Let's go small, very small. Oops. For some reason, this doesn't work. Oh, there you go. It's a very clunky tool. It's saying, oh, come on, I'm typing 1,000. Go for it. Yeah. Suggest that. No. 2K. $2,000 and a load of money afterwards if needed. Nope. Okay. Cool. We can't afford him. Alright. Left side. We've got Mackenzie. And I guess Isaac is on loan. Yes, he is. So for the left side, we're using fullback defense, which is correct. Okay. So we're going to try and get someone better. And sometimes I do this in January and no one better comes up. So, it's just a case of trying. Okay, so here, because we have quite a few people on different roles, then... Oh, okay, so this central defender, so this is the right role for Paul Downing. Okay. And then we've got Nathan Cameron with 11. Who else has 11? Cooney. So let's add some notes. Central defender, 11. And who else is on there? Devine. Central defender, 11. It's nice to have those to hand just in case. Okay. All right. Let me just go and see. George, he's a 10. Okay, actually I don't need that. Okay, because he's less than Nathan. Alright, cool. And then, let's move on to the next one. So we've got Soma, 9. And George again. Where is George? Defense. He's a 10 now. So George has improved. He's now a 10. I guess he must have improved his jumping reach, possibly. Not sure. But he is a 10 now. So if we go back to this, bump it up to a 10. Okay, you got a couple of options, but I'm guessing this guy's going to be difficult to get because of his visa. Let's just have a look. Um, So, yeah, he's not going to be worth getting. Okay, walk away from that. This guy's already over here as a Fijian. Alright, okay. It says listed for loan, but I can't afford to have any more loans. I've already used up all of them. Alright, so we're stuck with Sona. And finally, for the central defenders, I should probably update this filter now. Wide. So 11. Yeah, that's correct. Let's save this one, because save current filters, and we're looking at the wide centre backs. Save. Okay. Let's try and improve this. No improvements. Okay. Right. Defensive midfield. Eleven and ten. Again, let's save this, so I don't have to keep. Oops, that's not what I meant to do. Yeah. Okay. Save as a DM. Yep. Okay. So that is basically just quite a repetitive task of trying to get someone better. So I could get one of these guys. That guy hasn't been scouted. He's really, he's good, quite good. David Davis has been scouted. He's also very good. This guy's a little bit, a tiny bit younger. Let's see if this one will approach the sign. No, he doesn't want to come. Okay. How about David Davis? Approach the sign. He would come. Okay. Let's start by promising that. He's fine with it. Let's remove everything. Remove that. Whoops. I didn't mean to do that at all. Oh, no. No, 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 no. Oh, that is so annoying. I pressed the wrong button there. Okay. We might be able to get him later. Oh, no. Anyways. Mistakes do happen. Okay, so next. Moving on. It seems like we were going to get him as well. So that's quite annoying. That we didn't. So 10 for both our central midfields. Looks like we might be able to get some improvement, and hopefully if I don't middle up my buttons this time. So already try that guy, wouldn't come. Let's try some of these. Okay, let's say yes to that. Hopefully my buttons won't get muddled up this time. I always try and reduce everything. Okay, I'm gonna have to go for that. Okay, negotiate. Alright, take away all of these. Whoops. Let's be careful now as we're clicking away. Suggest, reduce that one again, and this time we're going to offer that. Suggest, reduce that one again, and we're going to offer appearance bonuses. Suggest, come on, he's coming, and we're going to suggest that. Okay, so at this point, do I just offer that? Yeah. Okay. Finalize. Okay. Harry Arthur. Nope, not interested. Okay. So we have one bid made. So that's for MC. His name is Jordan. Much. 7, which means a player at risk is brown. That's and bold them. There we go. Moving on to AMRs. What's going on here? Oh, there we go. So, AMRs, who have we got? Connor Stanley and Akinola. Whoops. Akinola is an 11, Stanley is a 10. That is correct. I could get one more potentially. I think this guy's going to be a lone one only. Yeah. Okay. Chelmsford. I can't have any more. I might be able to get this guy on a purchase. One, two. Okay, we'll make an offer for him. AMR is Jermaine Francis 11, which means the guy at risk is Stanley. And then moving on to AMLs, and you kind of get the idea. The thing is, it's quite difficult sometimes because it becomes quite a mechanic task. Pressing those buttons is sometimes you kind of click away and then do a mistake, which it can be quite annoying. Right, so how about AMLs? Got Jermaine Francis still, so I'm going to put him down as a AML 11 as well, in case we need to go back on that. This guy from Stoke, he's going to be quite expensive, isn't he? Yeah, they're not going to reduce that enough. Okay, so at this point, I either can make an offer for this guy, Mohamed Aminu, and he looks like he might be a good one. So let's keep an eye on him, or we could go back to AMRs. Nope. And see who else was available here, because there were a few guys, weren't there? Okay, so it looks like that guy is the only option. Okay. Okay, so let's see. Let's see, transfer, nope, post to sign, he doesn't have an agent, which is lovely. Well, he might do, but no, he doesn't. Ah, oh, work permits. Okay, so you wouldn't be able to come to us anyway. Alright, moving on to strikers. And this will be the last one. Strikers, okay. I'm going to try and find a 12 if there are any. There aren't. Okay, so that is it. So our transfer list is this. Obviously, we made a mistake with David, but yeah, hopefully we can still make an offer in the future. Oh, he doesn't want to be a... How about this one? Breakthrough? Nope, he's gone. He's gone as well. I'm not interested in him. This is one of our guys. He left. Okay, let's see if we get anything back. He leaves the club. Okay, so we need to get a replacement for him. And that, basically, David would be our replacement, but anyway. Okay, so that was a quick view into how I do transfers, and hopefully that will have given you some inspiration. Obviously, different people do different things, and some people rely a lot more on scouting and so on. But yeah, that's basically what I do. I can basically just look at attributes and try and increase those attributes little bit by little bit, incrementally. While we're here, we can choose our next captain. There we go. So Chris Porter, which is our striker, and Bradley Foster, which is our one of our goalkeepers, are going to be our next captains. I'm going to go with that. Press confirm. Yeah. Okay, let's see if that comes and bites us back in the butt at some point. Doesn't seem to. There we go. I've got total support from my players. That was amazing. Paul Downey is not happy that he's been... Oh, no, wait, hang on. There's a different concern. Let's try and convince him. No, he's not convinced. So I'm going to promise to give him some playing time. Okay. All right, and I'm going to leave it there. And hopefully that will, that was helpful. But yeah, so one thing you can do, just to summarize, is create some filters for the type of player that you want. It doesn't have to be necessarily in the way that I've set it up, but yeah, if you create some filters, it makes it much easier for you to look at players. And you know, having a good idea, like if you assess your own players, then you have a good idea of what you have already, and it's easier to see if there are any improvements out there. And the main thing is, as you're clicking around, don't make mistakes like I did. Yeah, that can be quite annoying when you are nearly about to close a deal with a player and then you click the wrong button. That can be really, really annoying, so watch out for that. Anyway, take care and enjoy, and thanks for watching until the end. See you next time. Bye!